Crystal Arriaga and friends knew after a couple of miserable days of no power in their Aquia Harbor neighborhood, they had to be the difference makers.
I'm used to giving back. I'm used to paying it forward. We're a military family. It takes a village to honestly just figure out where the gaps are and fill them in.
Arriaga traveled far and wide to find wood she's personally delivering to families like the Cooleys.
Silver lining, if you will, is just having great neighbors that look out for each other, help each other.
Brian Cooley says he recently ran out of firewood in the wake of a snowstorm that ravaged his Stafford County community. Monday's storm toppled hundreds of trees here, pulling down power lines. Crews from as far as Florida are working now deep into the night to turn the lights back on. Most here have power, but some remain in the dark.
The community did set up this emergency shelter behind me, filled with food, water, and warmth.
So I've packed up some food and some water for her.
Okay.
We're gonna get some soup to her, some hot soup.
Erica Mahood heads up this much appreciated space away from the wind and the cold.
That's what we do here. We all take care of each other.
It's utterly marvelous training on how to be absolutely miserable.
Michael McHugh counts himself among the lucky, his generator keeping his home just warm enough.
We shut off a couple of the doors because I have like an open floor plan. So we shut up a couple of doors, put some shower curtains up.
He's been doing his cooking al fresco.
I'm just doing some quick burgers.
And spent the last few days giving away his wood.
The coldest I heard was, it's 39 in my house. When is there going to be power?
Lucky because only moments before we chatted with him, his power was restored.
And all of a sudden, I look, and my deer came on out here. And that's what I saw.
I'm Jay Korf.
Let there be light. Let there be light.
For 7 News.